Welcome to PredictBASS, our software for predicting the response of subwoofers in a room. Unlike other programs for acoustic simulation, PredictBASS simulates a 3D environment in real time, updating as you walk around the virtual environment, change the room geometry, and of course, place subwoofers. In this quick start guide, we'll show you the most important features of PredictBASS so you can get up and running fast. When you first open PredictBASS, you'll be presented with this window, which asks if you want to use the room wizard. Selecting yes will open up a panel that allows you to quickly create a room with dimensions you can choose. This is great for rectangular shaped rooms, where you can simply enter the width, depth, and height, but PredictBASS allows you to also build the room yourself by placing walls. For this video, I'm going to click no. From here, you can see how PredictBASS works. You can walk around the virtual space with the arrow keys and use the mouse to change where you're looking, like playing a first-person video game. By default, we are presented with a single SSP-118 subwoofer with a wall behind it. For now, I want to delete all of this, so I'm going to hit Escape to show the mouse and select the menu in the top right. From here, I'll click Delete All, which gives me the option of clearing the room, and I'll click Everything to start fresh. Now, typically, you'd want to build the room you're working in first, but for this demo, I'm going to start by placing speakers. I'm going to hit Escape again and navigate to the left where we have our different tools. These include the Select tool, which allows you to move around and change the settings of selected items, the Move tool, which allows you to quickly move speakers or walls, the Build Speaker tool, which allows you to place speakers, the Build Wall tool, which allows you to place surfaces in the room, the Delete tool, which allows you to quickly select and delete items, the Mute tool, which allows you to quickly turn speakers on and off, and lastly, the Table view, which shows all the speakers or walls together so you can make quick edits to different boxes. For now, I'm going to select the Build Speaker tool, which asks which model we want to place. I'm going to select the VS21, one of my favorite subs, and click Build. Now we see a preview of where the speaker will be placed when I click the left mouse button. I can move around and also move the cursor to choose where I'm going to place the sub. This looks like a good place, so I'll click the left mouse button to confirm the placement. Notice how the frequency response in the bottom has already changed with one speaker. Now I'll add another VS21. Click, and here we go. Now I'll press Escape to return to the Select tool, and any other tool or menu, hitting Escape will return to the Select tool. Let me explain a little bit about what you're seeing below. Across the bottom, on the x-axis, is the frequency. Here we are showing different musical notes and their frequency. The y-axis is dBSBL, or sound pressure level, at that frequency. PredictBASS shows you how loud each frequency is at the listening position, which can be adjusted by simply moving around the virtual room. With two subs, standing in between, which is equidistant from both, creates the standard power alley, where both sum constructively and coherently. However, as we move more to one side or the other, PredictBASS shows how the differences in arrival times correspond to cancellations at various frequencies. These cancellations depend on the listening position and the spacing between the subs. As a result, PredictBASS allows you to quickly see the trade-offs of different placements of subs and how these placements in different listening positions contribute to the overall frequency response. Now that the Select tool is active, hitting Escape will release the mouse and allow you to choose a different tool. Let's choose the Build Wall tool and build a surface. I'll position it behind the subs and left-click to place the wall. Notice how the frequency response is updated again. This is because PredictBASS is also simulating the reflections off the wall. If we were to place even more walls, PredictBASS would calculate the reflections off each, as well as reflections between the walls. I'll hit Escape to return to the Select tool. Now, this is a good placement, because the reflections coming from the wall aren't causing much of a problem with the direct sound from each box. But suppose the wall was 30 feet back. I'm going to select the wall using the Select tool and push it back by, say, 30 feet. I'm going to add 30 to both Y positions to push it away from me. Now we have a bit of a problem, because the reflections off the back of the wall are causing cancellations with the direct sound, illustrated here in PredictBASS. The Select tool also allows you to select a speaker and quickly change the settings of that speaker. I can change its position in the virtual space here, including in the Z direction, to simulate flown subs. You can also simulate adding delay in milliseconds, as well as change the preset of the box, and even change which box it is. Perhaps instead of a VS21, we want a Kraken. Now we're really rocking the place. The Mute tool quickly allows you to turn various subs on and off. This makes it easy to see which placements may be hurting more than they're helping. Lastly, the Table view allows you to see all the speakers or walls and make adjustments. The first tab is for placement, which makes it easy to dial in various types of arrays. The second tab is for settings, where you can change presets, mute boxes, and add delay, all the things you can do within ControlBASS. Lastly, the third tab shows a list of all the walls in the virtual space and allows you to easily dial in room geometry from coordinates you may receive. There are two more important windows you can find in the settings. The first is the Enter Position panel, which allows you to set the listening position exactly, or simply see where you are relative to the placement of speakers. The second is the Graph Settings window. Here you can adjust whether the graph uses musical notes, shown below, or simply frequencies. You can also select what the minimum and maximum SPL values are, and adjust the size of the graph. Lastly, here you can normalize the plot, which makes it easier to find problem areas, especially at longer distances from the sources. We encourage you to head on over to our website and download PredictBASS for free today. We hope PredictBASS will enable you to deliver a more consistent low end at your shows.